Well, hello everyone, a very warm welcome to this web presentation of the latest collaboration between IWC Schaffhausen and Hot Wheels. My name is Chris Granger, I'm the CEO of IWC Schaffhausen. Well, it's that time of year again. We're almost ready to actually take our classic racing team back onto the track at Goodwood and fire up that straight six engine. And for us, there's always nothing quite like the thrill of putting this car back where it belongs, back on the track, to hear that engine roar once again. And those of you who've been watching the classic racing team quite closely, you would have noticed that ever since 2019, the livery of a 300 SL has actually carried the Hot Wheels logo on the sillboard just next to the exhaust pipes. And here, here today to find out exactly why that is and what got us to that point. And to explore that and discuss that together, I'm very, very honored to welcome Mattel's chief design officer to the webcast, Chris Down, live from California. Chris, how are you?
I'm very good, Chris. It's great to see you again. And and so wonderful, your location and the beautiful scenery of the wonderful 300 SL behind you. I'm in almost as exciting a place here in California at the Global Design Headquarters for Hot Wheels.
Our partnership started really with a friendship. And it's really that connection between people who are into cars and people who are into watches. It was a chance encounter with one of your designers, Manson Chung, who I met on Instagram because he's big into his watches, and it's no secret that I'm into my Hot Wheels. And that's how we met up, and I came to the design center a number of years ago, and I was totally blown away by this place.
There are 600 or 700 designers and developers and engineers and craftsmen that live inside of this building. It's a converted aircraft building. And of course, the origin story of Hot Wheels is very Southern California. It's made of innovators. And our founder was somebody named Elliot Handler. And he actually came up with the idea with some other esteemed creatives in 1968 and launched Hot Wheels back then. There were Matchbox cars and other miniature toy cars out there, but none performed and certainly none reflected the culture and the energy and the enthusiasm of what fast cars represented there in the mid-60s. When they rolled that first prototype, as the story goes, across the table, he said, those are some Hot Wheels, and Hot Wheels was born at that point. But inside of this building, Chris, you're totally right. You can't look around without seeing something like a full-sized Hot Wheels car, a replica in full scale, all the way through to what we're going to be coming out with next on the boards, on people's desks, as well as on the walls, the drawings, the 3D computer models, and all of the details that are going to be rolled out over the next year to 15 months for the Hot Wheels toy line.
I think the history of our two brands is sort of, in a strange way, quite closely related, because yours was started in 1968, as you said, by a couple and a man of the West Coast, Elliot and Ruth Handler, and ours was started by a man of the East Coast, Florentine Ariosto Jones from Boston, who came over exactly 100 years earlier in 1868 to set up the International Watch Company to make the highest quality and highest precision pocket watch movements for the US American market exclusively. And then, of course, the clue is in the title with the International Watch Company. Over time, we expanded our horizon massively and have started to make instruments, especially for the fields of aviation, for navigation, and later on for racing. And I think where our brands are really connected is that we started off with making mechanical instruments with a clear purpose, yours obviously being play, ours being time measurement. But over time, they've developed into so much more than that. And that is because of a passion for design, a passion for innovation and invention as well, coming up with that little bit of a crazy idea to push the boundaries that little bit further. And then also dealing with disruption from different products over time, and then becoming something highly emotional that people can relate to and that people also collect.
When you think of that in the world of toys and Hot Wheels, these are objects of desire. And if you enter the brand at age 3 or age 4 or age 5, and everybody has a Hot Wheels story, we've heard your Hot Wheels story as well, and how the connection between what you see in the real world could be played out through what you collect, what you accumulate, and what you prefer in Hot Wheels diecast cars is something that not only is a connection that kids and toys have when you first get introduced to them, but it is a lifelong connection that turns a kid toy player into a toy accumulator and then ultimately into an adult collector.
So when we got together, of course, it was clear we had to create something together, which was designed, which was engineered, and which is going to be very, very collectible. I think it's time to get to the matter in hand. And we're really, really proud and honored to present our collaboration project, the IWC and Hot Wheels Pilots Chronograph Racing Work Set. Let's have a look. Wow, there we are, a totally unique set, the Racing Work set, presented in an engineered toolbox limited to just 50 sets globally. And of course, there are two hero pieces inside this box, as you've seen. Number one, the strictly limited IWC and Hot Wheels Racing Works chronograph, a grade 5 titanium chronograph styled in the colors of the livery of the IWC Classic Racing 300SL. And from the get-go in this process, there was ever going to be only one material for this watch because Manson Chung and the design team, they're all very fascinated by titanium. It's got that huge automotive and racing link. We were the pioneers of titanium, actually, back in the day at IWC. So the case had to be made from titanium. I'm wearing it today, and it comes with that very, very unique Hot Wheels logo side engraving on the case. Inside this 43 millimeter chronograph, we have our unique IWC manufactured 69 caliber chronograph movement visible through a sapphire glass case back emblazoned with that 68 racing number you'll find on the car. Front, we have a black dial here with gray hands and indices, and the dial is really unique because we use a brand new laser etching technology to actually bring a very subtle checkered flag, racing flag pattern to the dial that actually plays in the light and sometimes is completely black, sometimes becomes visible, making that watch truly, truly unique. Presented on a black and silver NATO style textile strap, it really gives it that automotive and racing look, perfectly representing the car. And I think the car is the perfect segue. Chris, tell us about this unique model of yours.
The actual diecast is really special as well, and it's unique from the point of view of the level of detail and authenticity that it has to the full-size racing livery 300SL. The level of detail in terms of articulation, in terms of number of parts, and in terms of the graphics really have been brought to life by the masterminds behind it. Manson, of course, did the design, as you would expect. Steve Vandervate did the graphics on this car, and it is really, really spot on. In partnership with Nicolas from the IWC team, I think that the partnership has delivered something special.
I have to say, my hat off to Manson and the entire team. You've truly, absolutely outdone yourselves, and it's an absolutely amazing model. 50 only. I see my phone lighting up in the background. It's going to be very hard to get, but there is one very unique and meaningful way to buy one. Chris, tell us about that, please.
Okay, so the way to get your hands on one of these, in fact, the first one of these, is to go right now to Bonhams Auction House, of course, known for full-size vehicles. This is, I'm not sure if it's the first, but it may be the first time that this, through this set, you can get a 1/64 scale diecast. I am going to argue, and I am going to speculate, that we may even get more for this than many full-size cars. The proceeds from the auction are going to a great foundation and a great cause that actually inspires and helps to motivate the cultivation of makers in the future. Engineering and science and math, this is all something that's important both to the IWC company as well as the Hot Wheels company in terms of nurturing the next generation of creators. And so the Steam Labs Makerspace is going to be the recipient from the proceeds of the auction in collaboration with the 2-Bit Circus Foundation. So it's a great cause, it's a great product and great set to get your hands on. I think it's going to do extremely well.
We've talked about the car, we've talked about the watch, but of course there is one missing link, and that is the one man who both is wearing the watch and has worn the watch and is driving and racing the life-size car as well. And that is, of course, no other than former Formula One racing driver, broadcaster, very good friend of the brand, David Coulthard, live from Monaco. David, how are you?
I'm great, thank you. And gentlemen, I have to say, I'm disappointed to hear my voice because I was enjoying so much listening to both of you, Chris in Zurich, Chris in LA. Your passion, the engineering minds that you have, the creative minds, it's reminding me one of the greatest joys from my Formula One career. Of course, driving fast cars and winning Grand Prix was a thrill, but it was the opportunity to share with creative people that journey, that passion towards creating engineering art. And I think that we can agree Formula One cars are engineering art, absolutely watches are engineering art, and what Hot Wheels have presented since 1968, just a little bit older than me, is engineering art as well. So gentlemen, thank you so much for the broadcast so far.
Talk us a little bit through how that influences the way you race, the way you react, and how victory comes about when you're sitting in a multi-million dollar unique collectible vintage racing car.
The collaboration that you have as two incredible engineering companies has given me my proudest moment because, as you know, Chris Granger, giving me the opportunity to race my favorite car of all time, the 300 SL, the Gullwing, and the Tony Gase Trophy in 2019. It gave me the opportunity to compete, which I had been retired some time from Formula One, but thankfully that car is so good, it could have driven itself to victory. But to have that victory for the IWC racing team in front of my son was something really special, and I was just delighted I was able to deliver it to the checkered flag for you.
Well, thank you very much, gentlemen, for sharing your stories, all of the insights into the collaboration. And of course, David, for sharing your experience of racing the actual 300 SL. Thank you, everyone, for watching. I wish you good luck for the auction for the next week or so, getting your hands on one of those unique IWC and Hot Wheels racing work set. And of course, also keep your fingers crossed for the Goodwood members race tomorrow. See that 300 SL Gullwing back on the track in action again. David, thank you so much.
Thanks, Chris.
And Chris Down over in LA, of course, thank you for joining. Thank you for all your stories.
Thank you so much, Chris.
Thank you, everyone, for watching. Goodbye.